40 minutes, anyone that has been held in any prison, whether the devil likes it or not, whether the prisoners like it or not, whether those who locked you in there like it or not, within the next 45 minutes, you shall escape. Let me hear you shout the loudest, amen. Now begin to decree your escape. Which area must you escape today? Lift your voice, begin to decree. I must escape this sickness. I must escape this disease. This is a strange service. Don't let it pass you by. That stagnation must be escaped today. Whatever it is, let heaven hear you. Let heaven hear you right now. This is my hour of escape. My moment of escape. Lift your voice right now. From that wicked arrow from hell, I have escaped already. Lift your voice, somebody. Pray from the depth of your heart. This is your moment of escape. You must escape. You must escape. Your helper is here. Your help comes from the Lord. Your helper is here. I have escaped already. I have escaped already. Lift your voice right now and begin to decree your escape. Begin to decree your escape. In the next 45 minutes, my escape is established. Somebody pray right now. My escape is established. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your name forevermore. In the name of Jesus Christ. As you have declared your escape, not tomorrow, not next week, not next month, but your escape is right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Oh, his presence is here. Lift your hands. Heavenly Father, we are ready for that hot menu from heaven. The atmosphere is charged because you are here. By the blood, we gain access into this book of mysteries. And Holy Spirit, through your ministry today, we ask for understanding. We gain access to light. We gain access to Rhema. We gain access to revelation. Do what only you can do. Holy Spirit, I depend upon you absolutely, completely, totally, and wholly, because I can of my own self do nothing. Neither can I say anything without your empowerment. Therefore, I depend on you, sweet Holy Spirit. Intercept, interject, interrupt. This is your moment. In Jesus' precious name. For all you do, I vow to return all the glory in the name of Jesus. Amen. Remain standing, everybody. Please bring the prayer card. Stretch forth your hands. October 24th is 14 days from now. Everything you have written down on these prayer cards, begin to decree answers right now. Lift your voice, somebody. Begin to decree answers to all those prayers. Lord, we ask for conversion of all of these prayer points into testimonies in the name of Jesus. No one will come without an October 4th reality testimony. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we thank you for it, Lord. Be thou glorified in Jesus' precious name. Your prayer card is here. You are coming on the 24th with your testimony. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Give the Lord a hand, somebody, and give him a shout of praise. Please be seated.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. If you know you have escaped, shout with me, I have escaped. That's right. If you are sure you have escaped, shout with me, I have escaped. For that powerful ministration, let's give the Lord a hand. Amen. Also, you were blessed by mighty acts. Also, give the Lord a big hand for painting scriptures in pictures. Please take note of the following. I need to do this very quickly so we do not forget. Healing room will not hold today and will not hold next week Sunday. As we move to our new facility, we'll be announcing what does hear the Lord concerning healing room. Praise the Lord. So somebody said, but I desire healing. That's what this service is about. Amen. You have escaped sickness. Amen. Let me hear the loudest amen. Amen. So healing room will not hold today. It will not hold next Sunday. Is somebody glad to know 14 days to go to October 24th? What does that mean? This is our final communion service here. Next Sunday is our final anointing service here. And then the 24th. Man. We'll be in the dome celebrating the Lord. Amen. So please prepare to be a part of it. Begin to invite your friends, family members, and then, of course, bring them as you come. Deuteronomy chapter 11, very quickly, verse 10 to 11. The Lord quickened my heart this morning to share this with you. For the land whither thou goest in to possess is not like the land of Egypt, from whence ye came out. And you know we are coming out of Lanham. You say, I should tell you, where we are going is not like where we are coming from. What does that mean? Let's make sure we are decent. Let all things be done decently and in order. The way you argue with officials here is not how you should do it there. The way you struggle at the parking lot is not how you should do it there. Someone said, we bought everywhere. We didn't buy houses. So don't go and park in front of somebody's house. Where you see our officials, if you don't see officials there, it's not our property. Let's do things decently and in order. So car park is a major issue. If you want to park, then come early. We have several parking lots. This parking lot will be used that day, and then we have another parking lot a mile after the property that will be used. And since I'm not going to be here, you can park on my spot. It's free. So come early and then you shall be there. Praise the Lord. It's a new day for you. Shiloh 2021. I thought I would hear more than a conqueror. Shiloh 2021. I have never heard definition of more than a conqueror like this episode. That is when your enemy is afraid to fight. Come Shiloh 2021. All those things that have been struggling with you and I, upon our appearance, they will disappear. December 7th to 12th, 2021. So make sure you are a part of it. The Lord bless you. Today is our covenant day of escape, and I have good news for you. You have already escaped. Yeah. Unveiling the wonders in the world, part two. We are going to fly this morning. Engaging the wonders in the world, part two. We have 9 objectives. We may not be able to cover some in the first service, but we trust God in the second and in the third, so on and so forth, we'll be able to cover. But God knows who is here, so the one that concerns you will be covered. No, objective number one, we want to look at God's word through God's eyes. Who better to show you what is written like the one who wrote it? Objective number one, God's word through God's eyes. Objective number two, I want to show you a mystery show to me, God's record, rod, and refinery of wonders. That one we must cover in first service. Number three objective, we want to look at the importance and benefits of word encounters. How important and beneficial are word encounters? And I pray for somebody today, in this service, you have a definite word encounter. Amen. Then if we can cover this in the first service, we will. If not, then it's for second service. We call this the word made man mystery. The word made man. You know you are word made. You'll find out in a moment. Objective number six, how do I tap into the wonders in the word? Objective number seven, we want to look at the covenant of escape. There's a covenant of escape. A covenant of escape for covenant children. Number eight, how shall we escape? Because you and I will agree that we really need an escape right now. How shall we escape? And then objective number nine, we call this the Passover blood and our escape. By the communion today, you know, there are those that imprisoned you and there are those that are prisoners with you. Sometimes those who are prisoners with you don't want you to leave them. It's a mystery. One thing is for the prisoner to say, go. It's another thing for those who are with you there to say, how can you leave us like this? But in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, both the imprisoner and the prisoners shall let the imprisoned go free. Yeah. Now, very importantly, God's word through God's eyes Please take note of the following. God's word is God's encyclopedia of wonders. This should get an eruption in your spirit. The book called the Bible is God's encyclopedia of wonders. And I'll show you that in scriptures in just a moment. Point number two to note is that God's word is God's instrument of wonders. God's word is God's instrument of wonders. Point number three to note, as we look at God's word through God's eyes, is that God's word is God's production facility of wonders. So number one, God's word is God's encyclopedia of wonders. Number two, God's word is God's instrument of wonders. Number three, God's word is God's production facility of wonders. What do we mean by that? It is the place. This book is the place. You know, you can enter into this book as a destination. This book is the place where men and women, boys and girls, and please take note of it because age is not a factor. Men and women, boys and girls in this production facility are turned into entities of wonders. Please lift up your hands where you are. May this book make you another man and another woman. Amen. Let me hear the loudest amen. Now, if you look at those three statements very well, God's word is God's encyclopedia of wonders. That makes God's word God's record of wonders. That's where his wonders are stored. Open thou my eyes, Psalm 119 verse 18, that I may behold wondrous things in thy law. Exodus chapter 15 verse 11, who is like unto thee, O God, among the gods, who is like unto thee, for you are glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing what? Wonders. And the wonders are recorded in this book. This is therefore a wonder book. Joshua chapter 3 and verse 5. And Joshua said unto the people, sanctify yourselves, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. Where are the wonders described? Where are the wonders written? Where are the wonders recorded in this book? That's why we said this book is God's encyclopedia of wonders. It is God's record of wonders. Job chapter 9 and verse 10. Which doeth great things past finding out. Yay! Wonders without number. Every chapter in this book is a chapter of wonders. Even the beginning of the Bible where you have all the tables of content is a content of wonders. Can I tell you where you are? In the name of the Lord Jesus, 14 days ahead of you will be 14 days of amazing wonders. Amen. Let me hear somebody's loudest amen. Amen. Psalm 77 verse 11. The Bible says, I will remember the works of the Lord. Surely I will remember the wonders of old. Where are the wonders of old recorded in this book? Verse 14 of Psalm 77. The Bible says here, thou art the God that does wonders. If this is the word of God, then it is the record of wonders. Thou art the God that doeth wonders. Thou hast declared thy strength among thy people. Hallelujah. Psalm 136 and verse 4. To him. Oh, I love this. To him. To him alone doeth great wonders. His mercy endureth forever. Lift up your hands and if you can, your Bible, if you have it. I pray for you in the authority of the name of Jesus. From today, may your eyes be opened to this book of wonders. Amen. Let me hear the loudest amen. Amen. Come on, I need to hear that louder amen. Amen. But hear this, it's not only God's record of wonders, because we didn't say it is only God's encyclopedia of wonders. We also said, number two, it is God's instrument of wonders. Instrument of wonders. Now that takes us to a deep aspect of the word. That means this book is God's rod. The rod is the instrument. And thou shalt take this rod or this instrument in thy hand, wherewith thou shalt do signs. So the word of God is the instrument of wonders, or the rod of wonders, the rod of wonders, the rod of wonders. You find in Exodus 4:17, and now if you look at verse 20 or verse 21, I'm looking for that here. The Bible says that Moses left, he left with the rod of God. The rod of God is the word of God for us today. So you have that word in your hand. You are able to do wonders as you please. You don't come to church to look for wonders. You are a wonder walking on the street because you have the instrument in your hand. Isaiah chapter 11 verse 1 and 2, and there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse. And that was talking about Jesus. So Jesus, the word, is the rod of wonders. May 18th this year, May 18th, that makes it 14 years for me in ministry. May 18th, the Lord said to me, 14 years ago, all you had in your hands was the word of God. But he said, 14 years after, you now have in your hands the wonders of God. Verbatim, May 18th, 2021. But it's not mistaken. If you have the word and you sit with the word, what you end up having is the rod. And when you have the rod, you do signs as you please. Yes, lift up your hands. As you go back to your workplaces this week, because we shouldn't only be light in the church. We shouldn't only be seeing miracles in the church. As you step out this week, everywhere you go, miracles will take place because of the rod. What more? This is quite interesting. We said number three, that God's word is God's production facility of wonders. That means God's word is God's refinery. You come as a raw product into the refinery of the word, and the word refines you and makes you a finished project. Isaiah 8:18. I and thee that the Lord has given to me, we are for signs and wonders. This is when you become refined, refired as a sign and a wonder to your world. 2 Corinthians 3:18, as we behold him as in a glass, we are being changed into the same image from glory to glory. What is the glass? The word. This is why we must pursue word encounters, because hear this, it is the encounters we have from the word of life that makes our life to count. So pursue personal encounters. There's a catalog of my personal encounter. Maybe I'll share it second or third service. Just this year, not other years. Keep pursuing personal encounters. I remember when the Lord told me, he said, your intonation will not be a barrier to my manifestation. Don't try and speak like them. When you are sick, do you ask your doctor, where do you come from? No. You hear this, the only surgeon that can take your case. Everything he says, you'll be done here. Yes, sir. He said, your intonation is not the barrier. Bring me in. When I'm there to manifest, people will understand you well. You know, I've not tried to change how I speak after 3 years. Some of you, 2 months, nobody can hear you again. And nobody's still following you. 3 years now, I've not changed. And it's not. I came to school here. The way I talk, some of you, I was in school here, college, 4 years. By the time you are 15, there's no way your tongue changed. You now, you are 45. You now came here suddenly. No. 15, you can't change tongue again. You know when you know if somebody's tongue has really changed? When they're in trouble. You say, are you the same man? The man will begin to speak in his language. Praise the Lord. May you have encounters in the word. Now, what are the wonders in the word? Because of our time, let's quickly look at one. One wonder in the world. God's word is prophetic. That means it tells of the future. For we have a more sure word of prophecy. 2 Peter chapter 1, I believe, verse 19 to 21. In Luke chapter 1, verse 45, it says, blessed is she that believeth. For there shall be a performance of those things which are told of the Lord. Now hear this. The word of the Lord to you are the things told you of the Lord. The things you get in your personal study. And look at my Bible. You see marks everywhere. There are things he said to Moses. He's saying to Isaac, blessed is he or she that believeth. For there shall be a performance of those things which are told of the Lord. So the word is always telling us things of the Lord. Always telling us what is to come. Not just for the country, not just for the world, but for you. I remember when we're looking for the property and it was finally found, I heard deep down within me, Rehoboth. One, I won't talk that one much. Just, they strove, but it got to a place. No, the Lord has now made room for us. We shall be fruitful. We have not seen the impact of this church yet till we move there. You will be shocked. From every corner, government, everybody will take note that, hey, which people are these? It's scriptural. So go for your own encounters. God's word tells you of the future, because everything that the word says is ordained for fulfillment. Look at how old this book is, yet has never needed a review. Ancient word, also true, changing me and changing you. We have come with open hearts, so let the ancient word. We need to go back to some old songs. You see how powerful that choir ministration is? Some of this new stuff, you'll be wondering, where are these people hearing from? God's word is prophetic. Why? His word lives and abides forever. Do you know this word will outlive us here on the earth? You met the word. You will leave the word here, and the word will still be walking. Let me tell you something I just heard in my spirit. Even on your burial, after you fulfilled your days here, the word will still be walking. The word liveth and abideth forever. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 23. If it liveth and abideth forever, no need for review. Whatever it says will come to pass. So it is prophetic. Lift up your hands. Grace for you to walk in everything God says to you as an individual until you see it fulfilled. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Haven't you heard? His word will not return void. Oh, thank you. Matthew 5:18 is one scripture I love. There was a point I was struggling on the validity of the word. This is one of the scriptures God gave me. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle in no wise from the law shall pass. Till how many? Let me hear you louder. How many? That means what God has also said about your escape will come to pass. Let me hear the loudest amen, please. How then do you tap into the wonders in the world? Let's quickly look at one point and then we move. My God, we move to escape. We must be committed to a lifestyle of prayer and fasting for access to the outbreak of light. Some of you don't like fast. That's why your life is still slow. We must embrace it. You get to a point where you are living a fasted life. You can't even tell which one is Wednesday, which one is. If God gave them 2 times meal per day, I think you should think that it means something. Eating 3 times every day, I think is risky. God who created, he gave two. We read it in the epistle. He gave two. When I heard it, I said, chai. Twice a day, then a man will now be eating 6 times. Twice. That's God said, twice a day. Don't tell me medicine. God created you as a doctor. He said twice a day. They should eat twice. He gave them food twice. So any other thing outside 2 times, you are the one giving yourself. I know if you are the one giving yourself daily bread, it's dangerous. Twice. So we must embrace prayer and fasting, because it is in the midst of it light breaks forth. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 6. To 8. Now, in verse 6, it talks about the fast he has chosen. In verse 8, it says, then shall thy light break forth as the morning. That is something that will set you on a path of no return. Comes in the midst of a fast. Something just hits you. Bam! And suddenly your eyes are open. And, hey, has this thing always been in this book? Suddenly you have a way to go. You found a path to follow. You are gliding through life while others are struggling through life. Be committed to a lifestyle of prayer and fasting. Why? 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. You know this. The devil is out to blind your eyes and to blind my eyes. How do we have the blindfolding on our eyes taken off? Prayer and fasting. Don't do Wednesday with the church. If not, you can't go far. It's one thing what the church is teaching. It's another thing what God will show you. So embrace prayer and fasting as a lifestyle. Hallelujah. Lift up your hands. In the name of Jesus, within this next 15 minutes, whether the devil likes it or not, the one who imprisoned you there, I decree your total and complete escape. Amen. Let me hear the loudest amen. Amen. Psalm 124 verse 1 to 8. Place that on the screen as we go through this. Psalm 124 verse 1 beginning. The Bible says, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Israel say. Now let me hear you read. Now, can we read from verse 1 to 8 together with life? Let's start from verse 1. 1, 2, go. Let's go. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Israel say. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, when men rose up against us, then they had swallowed us up quick. When their wrath was kindled against us, then the waters had overwhelmed us. The stream had gone over our soul. Then the proud waters had gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord who had not given us as prey to their teeth. Let's read this one loud, please. Our soul is escaped as a bear out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken and we are escaped. Now, let's scream the last part together. One, two, go. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Who made? Lift your hands where you are. By the help of God, this moment is declared your moment of escape. Oh yes, that's right. His presence is here. By the help of God, this moment is declared your moment of escape. Please receive this from the depth of your heart. By the help of God, Jehovah himself, this moment is declared your moment of escape. I will say it one more time and receive this with everything within you. By the help of God, this moment is declared your moment of escape. Take your seat, please. What are we escaping from, you may ask? From the wickedness of the devil and his agents. Aluria katoshi batakandos ariadokata. From the wickedness of the devil and his agents. The devil has agents still imprisoning people. Demons and demonesses. Whoever may have been pointed at, an arrow shot at to imprison you, by the help of God, the mighty man in battle, this moment you have escaped. Oh, come on, let me hear the loudest amen. The question, therefore, is how do we escape? 3 points. And I want you to take this with everything you have on the inside. How shall we escape? Maybe I should remind you, in Hebrews chapter 2 and verse 3, this has been boiling in my spirit for some days now. How shall we escape? So there is a how to escape. How shall we escape? The first way, if we neglect so great a salvation. You paid nothing for it, yet you are neglecting it. How shall we escape? It is free of charge, yet you are bothered about what others think. How shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? So the first way to escape is be born again. And I mean be really born again. The pretense of salvation is plaguing our generation. Be really born again. Be really born again, not by title or by recognition, but in heart. Be born again and remain so. It gives us the answer. How shall we escape? So salvation is that bait of escape. You want to escape? Take this. Give your life to Jesus.
Nobody can manage your life like Jesus. No country can manage your life. Now, many of you came here looking for your life to be managed, but now it's already mismanaged. Jesus is the only solution. Now, no matter where you are, no matter what field, I was excited this week. Basketball is one of the things I love to watch. And I saw a Christian standing out. They asked him all kinds of questions. Say, no, I believe in Jesus Christ. He plays for the Orlando Magic. Jonathan Judah Isaac. Research him. He said, I will not do it. Everybody has their right. But I believe the solution to racism, according to him, is salvation. On public TV. Please wake up. Please wake up. How shall we escape? They tell you, hey, you need to deny Jesus to keep this job. Take your stupid job and give me my Jesus. How shall we escape? Number two, how shall we escape? One must keep walking in the light of the Word. The light of the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word was God. But here it is. The light shineth in darkness, and darkness comprehended it not. Imprisonment happens in the realm of darkness. When light comes, didn't you see when the heavens visited the prison of Paul and Silas? Light came into the prison. Everywhere was shaken. I'm talking about you getting to the realm of thunder eruptive word. Thunder, that is, when the word comes like the boom, chains fall off on their own. Keep walking in the light of the word. The light of the word. The light of the word. Psalm 74 and verse 20. We must keep walking in the light of the word. The light of the word. All right? They want me to give you that one. All right, look at this. Have respect unto thy covenant, for the dark places of the earth are full of the habitations of cruelty. The dark places of the earth are full of the habitations of cruelty. Cruelty exists in darkness. Wickedness exists in darkness. When light comes, darkness shows down. Let light show up, darkness will show down. So keep walking in the light of the word. Don't let your attraction and your appetite for the word end with this month. Let it continue. John 1:5. Thank you. Give me that in the Amplified. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not understand it. Ah. Or overpower it. Or appropriate it. Or absorb it. And is unreceptive to it. Ay. In your hand is what it takes to enjoy escape at all times. Finally, number three, how shall we escape? One must stay in love with God. In love with God. John chapter 4, verse 16 to 18. In love, real time love with God. Real time love with God. We must stay in love with God. We must stay in love with God. John 14, maybe, and verse 21, if you have that, give that to me. John 14, 21. We must stay in love with God. He that had my commandment and kept them is he that loveth me, and I will love him. And we will manifest myself to him. So stay in love with God. And we know that all things. Now, so that even if the imprisonment comes, it should be partial, and it should be working together for your good, such as the one of Joseph. It was all part of the plan, working together for his good. That imprisonment led him to the throne. So it means every imprisonment you are coming out of today, where should it lead you to? Let me hear you louder. Where should it lead you to? Now I announce to somebody, as you step out today from that imprisonment, you won't remain a peasant, but it will lead you to your throne. Amen. Let me hear the loudest amen. Amen. Shout with me, I have escaped! All right, stand on your feet right now and lift up your voice and begin to decree your escape right now, right now, right now, right now. Somebody get up with boldness and begin to decree your escape. Decree, 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 decree. This is your moment. This service is not permitted to end without you declaring your escape. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. You are escaping today. From every captivity of hell, every captivity spiritually, every captivity emotionally, every captivity physically. Call upon him in faith right now. Call upon him in faith. James chapter 4 verse 2. Call upon him in faith. Cry out to him. Somebody cry, somebody cry, somebody cry. Cry out to him, I say. Cry out in faith. 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 He said, you have not because you ask not. Cry out in faith. James chapter 4 verse 2. James chapter 1 verse 5 to 7. Now place those scriptures on the screen and begin to cry out. Cry for your escape. The escape of your children right now. He said, if any lack wisdom, let him ask of God. Ask of God. Ask of God. He said, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Let not that man think he will receive anything from heaven. Therefore, begin to decree, my escape is right now. Right now, right now, right now, right now. My escape. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. Lift up your hands where you are. Because of your cry today, I decree your escape is established. Now, there are some of you crying for the escape of your children, crying for the escape of your spouses, crying for the escape of your grandchildren, crying for the escape of your nation, even maybe. Whatever that situation is that you are crying for escape, I decree the escape is established right now. Let me hear the loudest amen. Before you go to bed tonight, now I want you to receive this one from the depth of your heart. Before you go to bed tonight, it will be confirmed that you have escaped. Yeah. I said it will be confirmed that you have escaped. Now lift up your hands and begin to give him thanks for your escape. Give him thanks. Give him thanks. Give him praise. Give him glory. Give him praise. Give him glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. There is an escape rope being thrown right now. How shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? You can imagine a person drowning and they throw the life safety rope to you and you say no. Ah, this is free of charge. You pay nothing for it. It is free. Free gift of salvation. How shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? Can you imagine how heaven feels when there are people who should not neglect, yet they neglect? How can you be helped when you neglect the help? Our help is in the name of the Lord that created the heavens and the earth. We're in dangerous days. Yes. If you have no escape route, I'm sorry for you. Wherever you are, with all heads bowed, all eyes closed, I want to escape right now. And I want Jesus. Just lift up your hands. I'll pray with you. Just lift up your hands where you are. I'll pray with you. I must escape right now. God bless you. Higher, higher, higher above your head. I must escape right now. I must escape right now. Hi, 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 hi. Somebody is wondering, should I answer? It may be too late when you are thinking of answering. It may be too late. I want to escape. Now, can I quickly ask, all those hands lifted up, quickly come towards the altar. Let's pray together. Your life will never remain the same. And you will take communion right here at the altar. Just come, just come. I must escape right now. I must escape. Make your way out of the aisles and begin to rush forward right now. I must escape. I must escape. Officials, start moving towards the communion table right now. This is the Passover blood of escape. I must escape. I must escape. Quickly come. Quickly come. People are responding. Don't waste time. Now, there are other individuals who must rededicate their lives to Christ. They were once born again, but for one reason or the other, they departed. I want to rededicate my life to Christ. I want to return back to Jesus. Quickly make your way. Quickly make your way. God bless you. God bless you. And God bless you. More people are coming. More people are coming. Be humble and receive your help. Salvation is that escape route. Quickly come. Now, those of us watching online, you also want to give your life to Christ. Our officials, I mean, the E-team will be reaching out to you, giving you a link that you should fill. Please make sure that you respond quickly. Those of us in front and those who need to join, can I ask you quickly come out? We're about to pray. Now, those of us in front, place your right hand on your chest. Pray this very simple prayer of faith with me. Say with me, Lord Jesus, forgive me all of my sins. Wash me in your blood.
Jesus, today I confess that you are my Lord and my Savior. Thank you because I have escaped. In Jesus' name, amen. Let me prove by you. Heavenly Father, look at these precious ones who have responded to this call today. Let the same grace that found them keep them serving you. And on the final day when you shall return, none shall be missing. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Can I have them serve communion right here at the altar before you take them out? As I promised, bring the communion here. All right. Please take. Now, take that in your hand. What you have in your hand is the Passover blood. And I want to quickly have us understand what we are taking so we don't take it out of tradition. This is very key. As we get ready to partake of the communion, please note that it was by the power of the Passover blood that Israel escaped from Egypt after 430 years. But the scripture tells us that Jesus is our Passover lamb today. What does that mean? It doesn't matter how long you have been in prison. If the blood of goats and bulls brought them out after 430 years, come on, tell me, what will the blood of Jesus bring you out of? Therefore, as you partake of this communion right now, I decree over everyone that believes God, this shall be your communion of escape. I said, this shall be your communion of escape. Amen. Escape from sickness. Amen. Escape from calamity. Amen. Escape from evil. Amen. Escape from arrows. Amen. Escape from wickedness. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So shall it be. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Partake of it with understanding as we give God praise. Oh my God. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. Please look this way after you're done with the communion. Follow our pastor. Of Jesus. It washes what? Now, please take note. One more Sunday here. Hallelujah. Next Sunday is our final Sunday. What's next Sunday? 17th. And it's our special anointing service. I'd like you to start praying this next 14 days towards the grand entry into Rehoboth. And it's in Rehoboth that we have our faith dome. That grand entry will be for you a new entry and new chapter. In the name of Jesus. All the announcements you had, including the stores that are available for renter, please reach out to NEI Michaels as we have on that announcement. Don't come to the office. Nobody will attend to you there. We do things decently and in order. Don't come and give service unit record. No. Go to NEI Michaels. They will inspect and see if you are qualified, and then we'll move that way. You are blessed. Amen. I said you are blessed. Amen. As you step out of this door, you are stepping out of the prison. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. Bring your hands to your chest. Share the goodness. Come on. One, two, go. Surely. God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the day.